Oh my gosh. I was chomping at the bit to get up here because I knew we had a chance of snow.
So weather headlines, let's break it down. Widespread dangerous heat, it's here. 105 to 115 degrees in some of the hardest hit spots. That heat dome traps heat at the surface, but it also traps particulate matter, and it will increase the opportunity for bad air quality.
And unfortunately, when you have hot temperatures coupled with extremely dry conditions, it does increase wildfire activity, and we have already seen that for this year versus last year.
So that's the high pressure system and what it's causing, but we also have the little guy, the low pressure system, and boy, it's packing a punch as well.
It's because that low pressure system is slowly but surely moving out the way, and as it moves, it takes the clouds along with it.
Have you ever tried picking up someone that weighs a lot more than you? Yeah, doesn't go so well, does it? It becomes very easy for that whole slab of snow to become very unstable. That avalanche warning is in effect until 7 a.m. on Friday morning.
We now have a red flag warning in effect for that Redding area because of the opportunity for thunderstorms. Thunderstorms with very little rainfall bringing us dry lightning, which could start new fires.
Those pulses of light, those are actually lightning strikes. So if you take a look at it, you can almost kind of see this nice counterclockwise circulation. Those are the showers, the rotation that's going up and around a low pressure system. A low pressure system is where you have rising air. Rising air warming, and you also have the opportunity for instability. That is where the opportunity for thunderstorms came from.
Oh my gosh, I was chomping at the bit to get up here because I knew we had a chance of snow. We're coming up Highway 80, and you know what? It was really just wet once you hit Colfax. By the time we hit the Eagles Lake exit, that's when these huge snowflakes that are hitting me in the face, it just came, I mean, they're just coming down in tons. So the opportunity for snow is going to be in our forecast. Take a look at some of the roadways. So this is what you're going to have to contend with. Right now, the action.
If you do not know what is going on with a roadway and you see a whole lot of water, and I know sometimes it's the shortest route, you do have to just turn around because it's not worth it. As far as our forecast is concerned, it's totally worth it. Take a look at what a difference it is. Over the weekend, it was hot. I was like, do I need to leave California? Should I be relocating? It's a lot going on around here. Well, take a look at this. Yesterday's afternoon high was 84 in Sacramento. Ooh, it's so nice. We had 90 in Stockton, 91 in Modesto. We had 93 in Marysville, 97 degrees in Oroville. Take a look at the foothills. They were in the lower to mid 90s, and we even had a triple digit again in Reno with 102 degrees. So I set you up, right? You're probably thinking, is today going to be that nice? Yeah, today's going to be nice too. So normal daytime high, you can see it's 93. Yesterday was 84. Today, I do believe we're still going to be in the upper 80s to near 90. So as far as I'm concerned, I call it hashtag winning. Weather headlines, nice temperatures on tap for the summer. A nice breeze coming in to help keep those temperatures down. And we are tracking the opportunity for more 100 degree temperatures, and they are going to be on the 10 day. Now we get to the big player. This is going to be a winter storm watch coming in Tuesday through Friday. Areas above 2,000 feet in elevation. Take a look at these totals. For the mountains, 3 to 6 feet of snowfall possible. For the foothills, 2 to 8 inches. But some areas, local areas, could see up to 2 feet. Yeah, that's a big weather maker. Take a look at this, what this particular model is showing. 30 inches for Squaw Valley, close to 40 inches in Sierra Tahoe, as well as Kirkwood, and that is Tuesday through Friday. Now, here is the caveat. This could be the biggest storm of the season, and as far as confidence levels, because it's still a few days out, we do believe it's going to be a major rain event. But here are my questions. Will this storm linger? Will it stall out? Will it be fast moving? Which areas will see the most rainfall? And what about total accumulation? That's something we're still kind of on the fence about as well. But here's the takeaway. If this system does come through Tuesday through Friday and it lines up and approaches these areas that we're expecting, we could see 2 to 3 to 4 inches of rainfall. That's going to be a big deal for areas that are adjacent to wildfire areas, burn scar areas. You could have some debris flows. So here's a look at your satellite as well as your radar. And every time you're seeing a white spot there, like those pulses, those are lightning strikes. And we have been looking at the opportunity for lightning strikes in the Sierra
over the course of this afternoon. Now let's talk about that Beckworth complex. So it started out the Dada fire on June 30th. Then we had the Sugar fire that was on July 2nd. And then they combined those two fires to actually make it the Beckworth complex. Again, that started the name actually becoming one particular fire that was on July 4th. And you can see it is 55,000 acres. It is 8% contained. And the concern is when you have thunderstorms that bring rainfall are wonderful, but we've had a lot of thunderstorms with very little rainfall, and it is those outflow winds associated with those thunderstorms that can actually cause those fires to grow. That is our concern for this evening, as well as for tonight, and the possibility of more thunderstorms as we move ahead. And something else, of course, very dry and very hot.